Welcome everyone to another fun low level video. On the Linux kernel mailing list, there is a pull request for x86 memory management changes for 5.13, implementing concurrent TLB flushes, overlapping local TLB flushes with remote TLB flushes, TLB translation leukocyte buffer, a hardware circuitry in most modern processors or additional integrated circuits, think Motorola 68K, for example, 68000 early versions, or maybe even early Sparks had a dedicated integrated circuit for that. It was not in CPU integrated. Kind of memory cache to reduce the time it takes to use memory locations in hardware and processors in, yeah, since the 386 and similar processors, to map the virtual to physical addresses. This, although this is not exactly maybe like that here, just Wikipedia graphics. This is processor specific, so this is different between ARM, MIPS, PowerPC. The PowerPC, for example, has reverse page tables. Spark, at least early ones, had software managed page tables. x86 has one of the most complex, of course, hardware walking page table. That also means that on some architectures, some CPUs, this in-memory format is not as fixed, specified. Probably Spark, not sure, PowerPC maybe. On x86, it has a very specific and complex, of course, in-memory format due to the nature of 286, 386, and PAE, and so on. So what this does is, if there is a virtual, the first time the processor needs to fetch a virtual address from memory, this address is of course virtual because all the processors run in their own virtual address space, since properly protected mode operating systems, since 386 and stuff. And so the TLB slots store the translation result. Again, some processors might have this OS software managed. And so this is cached for performance, because walking the page table with all the CPU-specific data structures is quite expensive. And I tested this with 5.12, so this cleanly applies to 5.12 as well. I've compiled the kernel, my favorite benchmark here, compiling open source stuff. And leave me in the comments below if you want to see more stuff. Maybe I should every week some 10 minutes of stuff. But long story short, so compiled that here, epic thread ripping AMD Ryzen 1550X, a little bit of curve optimized and quite fast memory. Compiling itself, so usually this took the last time some 5 minutes, 30, like 29, 31, depending. The problem is also modern AMD Agiza, each time I boot, the memory training is different and the turbo boosting is different. So each time I reboot, I get some second or two different. But anyway, if I usually get like around 5:30, this is now 5:22.9. So some 7 seconds faster, which is of course, hey, this is better than the usual curve optimizing and memory overclocking stuff. So I'm surprised, I didn't expect that. This is as advertised, so it's always good when some independent people test that. Can only encourage more people testing stuff, playing along at home. Could also crash, right? Applying some random patch from the Linux kernel, and this could also go up in flames and stuff. Hopefully not as much in flames as AMD ASUS Agesa stuff of burning our memory channel. But yeah, I can confirm this. They advertised single percent performance in this bench, measurable couple of percentage points. So for me, this is like around 2.5. So worst case 2, my favorite Lua thing. So if worst case we have here like 29, then this is like nearly 2% faster, 98% here from 522.9 to 529. And maybe otherwise I get like 530, 531. Leave me in the comments below. Maybe also the test best with performance boosting disabled. This is scientific benchmarking with random frequency boosting glitching stuff. It's like, yeah, apples and oranges. But yeah, I can confirm. So for my use case, it's like 2.5% maybe for compiling open source stuff here, which is of course performance you otherwise need in next non-existing AMD SKU 4. I went over the patch here. It's not the easiest to read, of course, due to the nature. This stuff is relatively complex, just a little bit. A bit of the patch is renaming others to multis, like, okay, I think this is a pure rename. I don't see anything else. So it's like, yeah, basically this is just pure rename because renaming and renaming. So it's like basically until here, it's no operation of just renaming stuff. The other nature also here, continue renaming. So okay, all of this, if we factor out renaming, it is even a smaller patch. But the nature of this, also bool is lazy, this is in TLB flush H. So yeah, quite some lines of just removing some bool. And we are like already 20% into this. Otherwise, the nature is quite complex to understand. Also rename and comments. So still not so much going on. People always think everything is so much magic. Hey, still renaming. So and I think until here we have purely only rename. And still, this is not rename. Anyway, and this is, what is this? Mangle long MM spec. The rest of the nature is, of course, this kind of stuff is rather low level, and SMP processor ID initiating, and then IRQ count VM. By the way, why does this happen? So maybe I should also mention, so what this is doing is, in the translation locus height buffer, these mappings are constantly modified. You create processes, you allocate memory, where is even the, here. I'm showing you wrong here. So why is this even manipulated? So each time some memory allocation happens, which of course with 32 threads by 4. Whatever gigahertz, quite a lot. Allocations, deallocations, processes, fork, exec, and so relatively high memory management pressure. So this is why this is actually quite kind of amazing 30 years later in Linux. And what is also the performance difference when you compare raw performance of some heavy CPU cycle workload to macOS and Windows? Linux usually comes ahead, especially to the BSDs as well, due to just 30 years of this kind of optimization. This is of course pretty amazing. Also, this is security related, right? If you would invalidate this translation locus height buffer, I think some deallocation, multi-threaded or in general just deallocation, right? You need to update this mapping, otherwise if you free memory and you wouldn't invalidate the translation locus height buffer, the process, the user space process, could still access the previously cached mapping. So this is of course security related, and they say also, depending on the Spectre and Meltdown and stuff, performance mitigations, security mitigations are active, could have a higher impact. I should say my 2.5% here that I could measure are actually with, I boot with mitigations equals off or something of that sort, because we need each extra performance here to build all the 15 and plus counting architectures. So yeah, nice stuff. And also, because this applies cleanly to 5.12, I will actually include this in the 5.12 update, so that T2 users here of, also, I wanted to, not T5, T52, what? You Google, and of course, you get some Nazi shit, because obviously you get, there's always some Nazi shit for everything. Anyway, T2, and so yeah, continuing making T2 the most optimized just raw Linux distribution out of there. I hope you learned something and enjoyed this. I probably should quickly check if we had any comments. Welcome, Danny. I hope you learned something and found this useful. And if you're interested in this stuff, T2 is this source distribution, one of the older Linux distributions history since 1998, and just raw Linux for you to play along at home. This also only applies to x86, right? You see this already here, so not your PowerPC and ARM stuff is not magically getting any faster. And where's my mouse cursor? There's my mouse cursor. This is all in x86 memory management stuff. So yeah, there's that for that. But otherwise, Amazing stuff, and T2 probably. How did I get there? Actually, only checked if we have 512.1 already, but we haven't. So we continue building that. Also, one last thing, and then we call it a day. I probably reboot and try the RM8 AMD 5950X. Silicon Lottery appears to maybe tiny little bit better, maybe with manufactured now 4 or 5 months later than my initial processor. Maybe in general, it could be that the process is a little bit more sophisticated. Maybe the CPUs are now a little bit better, or it's just Silicon Lottery, and this time we are just more lucky, got a CPU more from the center of the wafer or something. And maybe actually reboot and try a tiny little bit stricter memory timings and a tiny little bit curve optimization and see if I can, just for the sake of science and improved build timings. I said I'm a little bit done with overclocking and stuff, but maybe a tiny little bit would be cool if we get this to 5 minutes 20, wouldn't it, for building 15 architectures all night long.